Zookeeper is a scene management tool for 3DS Max. With our outliner-like tree views, you can manage thousands of objects quickly and easily. In the schematic view, you have complete node-based editing of all your objects, controllers, and materials in one place. Manage selection sets, and use the advanced layer management to create nested layers and easily navigate your layers in your scene. Here you can see we have a sky dome and a cloud setup. We can drag these into the schematic view and then start dragging out the properties that we want to expose. If we take these, we can put them into a cluster node by grouping them all together. Once we have our cluster node, we can name it, and then we can expose the different outputs that we want to have at our fingertips in the end result of the node. Just by piping those into the input, we can go back out to the cluster node and you can see that we have only those options. This way we can set the properties for the sun, the clouds, and the sky without having to be bogged down by a huge amount of different nodes. Zookeeper will allow you to manage thousands of objects in your scene with speed and agility, as well as layers. You can customize the view to set up different tabs and filter different types of objects like lights or cameras. You can also create custom views and sort by different things like names or even a search criteria. Docking and customizing the Zookeeper view is easy. You can set it up to your own particular workflow. Set properties on layers as well as create different nested layer groups in order to manage your layers in a more effective way. This latest release of Zookeeper has a brand new schematic UI that focuses on speed, flexibility, and ease of use. You can see we can adjust the color of the light right from the node, hide and unhide our character, and set different properties for it. If we go to any node, we can double-click on it to bring up its appropriate editor, or we can go into the rollouts and adjust those properties right there. We can turn on the map show in viewport here, and then we can adjust the color of this light. You can see there's a huge amount of speed going through, panning around a lot of different nodes. Just double-click on any modifier and that'll bring you directly to that modifier in the stack so that you can edit it easily. Another new feature of Zookeeper 2.0 is the ability to manage selection sets in a tree view. You have a new selection set tree, and you can put any selection sets or current selection sets in there, easily select them, rename, or drag and drop objects in or out of them. You can even create a selection set right from here, and just grab those objects from the viewport and drag them in. This lets you easily manipulate and select selection sets using Zookeeper. Using Zookeeper's advanced tree view, we can edit the same parameter on multiple objects at the same time. If I drag these objects in and search for radius, you can see that I can adjust them all in relationship to each other or set them all to a single value. If I do this on a more complex setup, I can just drag these objects in and I can search for a parameter they all have in common, something like stretch. I'll bring up the stretch and now I can just scrub and you can see that in relation to each other the scrubs will be increased. I can animate this over time and then search for something like angle. Select two objects that have a bend and I can animate that angle of the bend over time. Lastly, I'll search for twist and I'll go to the end and just animate the twist on all of these objects. Using multi-edit can be a powerful tool in order to adjust multiple objects at the same time. Zookeeper allows you to work in one unified interface that's fast and robust in order to get your work done faster and more efficiently in 3DS Max. Let Zookeeper 2.0 help you tame your 3DS Max scenes.